Hello there.
Welcome back to another scripting video. Today we're going to be taking a look at custom properties in Roblox Studio. Okay, so what are custom properties? How can they be used and why should we use them? And first of all, I want to actually explain what I mean when I say properties. By properties, I mean like attributes attributed to different things in your game. So like this spawn point over here, if you expand it, and then you come down and you look this properties bar. The properties bar is in view and you'll see this little properties tab icon here. Click that so it's open, and now you can see all the customizable properties about a certain object. So at the moment I'm looking at my spawn point and I can do some basic changes with it. I can make its reflectance really high so it's reflecting the sky. I can change its transparency, I can make it partially invisible. Obviously that's the decal that's still there. But if I was to delete the decal, as you can see, the part is now completely invisible. I'm just going to reverse that change and do cast shadow. As you can see, when I toggle the cast shadow property, it changes the shadows on and off. You can also change this in game lighting and just do global shadows on and off, but I'm going to leave that on for now for the sake of the video. Alright, so to start off with, I'm going to give a little example of a basic property called anchored. So anchored is basically the property that chooses whether or not your part stays in one position or not. It basically anchors it to whatever position it's in. So as you could see just then, that was unanchored, and if I just click anchored again, like it fell last time, it won't fall this time I unanchored the base plate. That's what happened there. It is now anchored and it will not move from its position. That's how people create obbies and things like that, floating in the air, is with the anchored property. So let's toggle this property in a script. So I already have a pre-written script just over here. Okay, so let me explain what's going on here and its behavior. So script, obviously we're talking about the script that we're currently in, this script right here. We're talking about its parent, the parent-child system. This part is the parent, and we're getting its property. Because you see, when I do the dot, it comes up with all the customizable properties I can change about this part in particular. Each item, like a mesh, will have different, you can do change mesh IDs and things like that. But for now, we're just sticking with the part and we can change its anchored property. Change its anchored property to true. So what'll happen is it will start off with an anchored property. So let's say I forget to anchor this part, right? Through this button right here. The script allows you to manage this without actually having to be in your game. So your game works for you without you having to be constantly there doing it yourself. Because imagine you have 1,000 servers of your game and you have to join each game and anchor every part. Imagine how painful that would be. So that's why we use property scripting, okay? And we've got a wait 3 that's pretty self-explanatory, it's just going to wait 3 seconds. And then we've set, again, script.parent.anchored, so it's anchored property. The one down here, where is it? There it is, anchored. If we click that, that works just as well as the anchored button up there. So I'm just going to leave that off now because the script's going to do it automatically for me. So as you can see, when I click the part, the anchored is equal to false, but in our script, we've set it to true. We're going to wait 3 seconds and it's going to be false. Run. We're waiting 3 seconds and there it goes. It's dropped down because its anchored property, as you can see down here, is now set to false. Now there are lots of different properties you can do this with. I mean, I'm talking, let's say we want to change, let's change its transparency, and we do .transparency is equal to 0.5. So now we're changing how transparent or how much you can see through it is. So it's going to be half, it's going to be semi-transparent, and yeah. Next we're going to, after that we can wait 3 seconds and we'll do script.parent, which we're referring to the part, the script parents, script's parent, and we're going to do dot transparency is equal to 0. So then it will go back to fully non-transparent. So let's click run. We'll see how that works. And there it goes, from half transparent to no transparent. All right, so let's explore some of these properties, shall we? So we can do this. Let's have a look at them, shall we? Script dot parent dot. Let's say we want to change its name. Dot name is equal to, I don't know, dumb underscore part. I'm sorry, part. And we click run. If we look here in our workspace, the part has been renamed, the part's attribute of name has been reset to dumb part, like over here in our script. Anyways, guys, that's going to be all for this video. It's just been a quick one to explain how properties work, why you should use them, and where they're useful. But other than that, thank you guys so very much for watching. See you next time.